Welcome to the Google Play community. With over 2 billion users around the world, it's important for all developers to follow a few basic guidelines to keep things running smoothly. Following these policies will not only keep your app in good standing on Google Play, it will also help keep your users safe and protected. In this video, we'll teach you some important policies, explain the app approval process, and show you where to go for more information about everything Google Play. Here are a few of the most important policies to remember when designing your app. Please make sure that you create your own original images, sounds, and videos to promote your app. Your app icon, feature graphic, music, and any other creative assets you upload to your store listing should only include content you have the right to use. If you've been granted permission to use assets owned by others, you can notify the app review team in advance through the Play console. Earning our users' trust is critical. We want users to trust the apps and games they download from Google Play, which is why user privacy is at the forefront of our policies. For example, your app should request only the permissions that relate directly to its core features and be clear about the personal data it uses. If your app is designed for children or may appeal to children, it needs to follow a few additional rules in our Families policy. For example, games meant for kids shouldn't show ads with mature content. To learn more about all of Google Play's policies, visit our Developer Policy Center. Once you finish designing your app in compliance with our policies, it's time to think about how to best represent your app on Google Play. First, you'll set up a store listing so users can easily and clearly learn all about your app or game before downloading it. Unrelated or irrelevant words, like spamming through keywords or referencing other brands in your store listing, could get your app rejected or suspended. Use clear and simple language to share what's interesting and exciting about your app so users will understand what makes it special. And just like your app description, the images in your store listing should be appropriate for all ages. Next, you'll fill out a content rating questionnaire administered by the International Age Rating Coalition to receive your app's rating. You'll answer questions about violence, language, crime, in-app purchases, and other types of potentially restricted or adult-oriented content to help users decide if your content is right for them. Thoughtfully consider your answers to these questions to ensure they accurately represent your app. Check out the policy courses on Google Play's Academy for App Success to learn more. Next, your app will go to our review team, which will compare your store listing with your app's experience. Your reviewer will take a look at your app's content, including ads, store listing, and more, to make sure it complies with all our policies. Google Play also uses powerful machine learning to flag and remove potentially harmful apps that violate our policies. When review is complete, Google Play will let you know via email and through your Play console if any policy violations have been found. Make sure you keep your contact info up to date in the Google Play console so we can get in touch with you. After you've submitted your app for review, you can check its status on your Google Play console. When your app is approved, it will go live on Google Play, where it can be downloaded by over 2 billion Android users. Since policies evolve over time, it's important to stay up to date with the latest changes. We'll reach out whenever there's a big update, but you can also follow us on our blog and Twitter. Ready to get started? Visit the Play Academy and the Developer Policy Center to learn more about our policies, pick up new skills, and find answers to all your policy questions. Thanks again for joining and being a part of Google Play.